वेलकम टू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी। दिस इज आ यूजी लैब। We having number of plant specimens and study material preserve and study during practicals. These are specimens belongs to algae. These are fungal specimens. These are specimens of bryophytes. Pteridophytes. Gymnosperms, and angiosperms. Showing these specimens improve theoretic knowledge of practical aspects related to plant morphology. Wherever we go for excursion, we collect the specimens and preserve it. These are the fungal specimen collected during our excursion. This is polyporous. This is nest fungi, Favolus. And Ganoderma. This is arc indicator we use to measure growth of plant with the treatment of different hormones. This is imbibition pressure equipment we use to measure imbibition pressure plant material including seeds. This jar is filled with seeds or plant material. When it absorbs moisture, it creates pressure on pistil and indicates pressure through the needle. This is microtome. We use to take thin section of plant material, that is root, stem and leaf. Most of the permanent slide of TS, LS, VS of plant material we prepare in our department. वी हैविंग वन ऑटोक्लेव विच वी यूज टू स्टरलाइज प्लांट मटेरियल फॉर टिश्यू कल्चर एंड मशरूम कल्टिवेशन. Wherever you go for excursion, we collect plant specimens and prepare herbarium. These herbarium we keep separately according to the family in this shelf. This shelf having herbarium belongs to family Solanaceae. This is herbarium of Solanum xanthocarpum. Solanum nigrum. These herbarium help for further identification of plants. We having separate lab to conduct experiments on plant tissue culture. This is wooden inoculation chamber with UV light facility and normal tube light. There is provision to insert hands as it is a closed, we are getting less contamination and good result during plant tissue culture. Here we have inoculated nodal sector of clerodendron in MS media. Today it's 9th day of inoculation without contamination. In this lab, we conduct several experiments on anther culture, embryo culture, somatic tissue culture. When we put somatic tissue in culture media, cytokinin and auxin play important role for rooting and shooting. High ratio of auxin to cytokinin favor for root initiation, while high ratio of cytokinin to auxin favor shoot initiation.
On behalf of Botany Department and on my personal behalf, I, Dr. Imtiaz Hussain Zahid, Assistant Professor, Department of Botany, Abhyuday Namdar Senior College, Pune, welcome you all for today's program, Applications of Advanced Instrumental Technique. First of all, I am very thankful to the coordinator, Dr. Khurshid Ahmed, for giving us opportunity to present the research topic on hydroponics. We are also thankful to Principal Dr. Shaila Bhutwala, Head Department of Botany, Dr. Naseem Deshpande, my friend Professor Asif Sheikh, and active team members of this committee. We are also thankful to our President Dr. P.A. Inamdar for sponsoring this event for the transformation of science to all the education institutions, especially to the minorities college of Maharashtra. Now, my friends, we are going to discuss about hydroponics. You all know hydroponics means water. Cultivation of plants in the water. How can we cultivate the plants in water? To the water, we apply the nutrient water and circulate to the plant so that plant can grow. Let us discuss about this research methodology. First of all, we take the desired type of vegetable which we are growing in this system. You can take tomato, you can take capsicum, you can take cabbage, or you can take medicinally important plant. In today's presentation, in today's interaction, we are going to discuss about cultivation of sweet capsicum. What is sweet capsicum? We commonly call in Hindi as Shimla Mirchi, which belongs to family Solanaceae. We take these seeds of the Shimla Mirchi and we take this Shimla Mirchi seeds in the Petri plate, which are available in the market. To these seeds, we take the sponge and we cut the sponge of the desired size what we need to fit in the system. For example, we have taken 25 by 25 and to this 25 by 25, what we are doing in the center of it, we are with the help of knife, what we are doing, we are making the hole in the center of this one. After keeping this one, we are removing and with the help of forceps, without disturbing the seeds, slowly we are taking the seed, we are taking the seed and we are keeping the seed in the center of this one. After keeping, taking, we are keeping in the a tray which is made up of steel. You can use plastic tray. Then we are doing it for maybe 100, maybe 50, maybe 250, depending upon how much we are using for this cultivation. We have kept in the seeds. You can see the seeds. We have kept the seed inside and we are keeping here in the tray. We are taking another one. We are following the same procedure. We are cutting in the center. You can see it is going up and down. Then we have taking the seed. Again, to the seed we are keeping in the center to it. Then we have kept in the tray. We have taken another one. We have done the small hole in the center. Then what happened? You can see. Then we are taking the another seed of the pepper, which is also known as bell pepper. Capsicum is also known as bell pepper. And we have kept in the center of the sponge. Can you see here? We have kept the center of it. After keeping this, what we are doing, with the help of barber spray, in the barber spray is nothing but it contains only the water. So what we are doing, we are adding water, we are adding water to the sponges. We are adding water to this seed. What happened? These seeds, we keep it in the laboratory for 6 to 12 days. After that, we remove this sponge and we are keeping into the hydroponic system. We have seen the hydroponic. What happened in most part of the world, water is a big problem, especially to African countries and other places. So what farmers are doing, they are cultivating the vegetables in the sewage water. When they are cultivating the vegetables in the sewage water, the health of human beings is getting affected. So for better health, we need the better vegetables. For that, the hydroponic system is the best solution in this 21st century. We can cultivate the commonly used vegetables like tomato, like mint, what we call pudina, like spinach, what we call palak, which is very nutritious vegetable, which contains iron, calcium, manganese, magnesium, folic acid, vitamins. So we can cultivate the spinach on this hydroponic system. We can also cultivate the sweet capsicum, what we call Shimla mirchi. Now we are going to see how Shimla mirchi is cultivated on the hydroponic system. The hydroponic system, which is made up of plastic pipes or steel pipes, we have used the plastic pipes. These plastic pipes are 10 feet long, and these pipes we make small 2 mm hole at the top, and we give the gap of around 1/2 feet, and these pipes are interconnected with the other pipe, so that depending upon how much big system you want, that many pipes you can use. It is connected to the water tank, and in this water tank we keep the fresh water. To this fresh water we are keeping the fertilizer, that is liquid fertilizers like NPK, nitrogen, potassium, and other minor elements like zinc and so on. And this water tank is connected to the electric current, and when we keep the electric current on, the water moves from one pipe to other pipe. You can see this, the system in tank, there is water. Inside the water, we have taken the liquid fertilizer, and this liquid fertilizer are mixed. Depending upon the system, we can take 10 gram, 10 nitrogen, 10 phosphorus, 10 potassium, depending upon how many plants we are using. For example, we have used for research purpose, so we have taken a small 250 grams of nitrogen, 250 grams of potassium, and 250 grams of other micro elements like calcium, zinc, and so on. And we have mixed to the system, and this fertilizer got mixed with water, and it gets circulated to the water, because we have taken only 150 the capsicum annum plants. As we keep the motor on, water from inlet goes to the pipe, and it circulated from all the pipes, and again from outlet it come back to the tank. The capsicum, which belongs to family Solanaceae, it is believed to be native of tropical South America. It is highly ruminative vegetable, cultivated in most part of the world, including India, in part of Maharashtra, UP, Karnataka, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, are commonly cultivated sweet capsicum. It is rich in vitamin A, vitamin C. For example, 100 grams of edible portion of capsicum provides 24 kilocalories of energy. In that, 1.3 grams of protein, 4.3 grams of carbohydrate, and 0.3 grams of fat. As you all know, it is used throughout the year. It is available throughout the year. It is commonly used in pizza stuffing, burger making, and as a vegetable. It is economically important, but growers are not in a position to produce good quality of capsicum. It is because of erratic behavior of weather. The crops grown in open field are often exposed to fluctuation level of temperature, humidity and wind flow. Now, to overcome this, we can cultivate this one in laboratory, on your terrace, on the buildings, in the housing societies, so that we can get the different types of leafy as well as other vegetables freshly available. The capsicum, botanically known as capsicum annuum, we have taken the seeds and soaked in the cut sponge and rising seedlings, 25 mm by 25 mm size of sponge was used. In the middle of each block, one seed was placed and water was sprinkled in the morning 6 and evening 6. After 15 days, the seedlings got germinated and seeds were treated before putting into the blocks. The seeds were kept into the block and total 75 seedlings of capsicum annuum was transplanted to the quaternary node depth into the set of hydroponic system. You can see the system which is there, and this system, after seedling, we have made the spray. The spray consists of the fungicides in order to kill the fungus so that there should not be airborne pathogen attack to it. We have done it every month where the crops was growing. We have sprayed only if we noticed that there was plant attacked by the fungus. The system, what we have done, as the plants were growing and there is no soil, if there is no soil, the plants may fall down. So we have tied with the plastic ribbon, and plastic ribbon were used and tied to different plants. At the time of flowering, plastic ribbons were shaken so that pollination takes place properly, and it got continuous. Then we have seen that very good amount of capsicum was noticed on the plant. We have taken the measurement, 9.54 centimeter was fruit average size, fruit breadth was 7.24 centimeter, and fruit approximately weighting 125 grams. You can see the fruits of capsicum. Now, why we should use the hydroponic? What is the importance? What is the benefit? What advantage it have over the soil vegetables? Up to 90% more efficient use of water. We can conserve the water. Water can be reused. Less wastage of water. Production increases 3 to 10 times in the same amount of space. For example, in 20 square feet area, we can cultivate same crop which is equivalent to 1.5 acres. Many crops can be produced twice or thrice as fast in a hydroponic well-managed system. Grown vegetables can be just as nutritious as those grown in the soil. It is 30 to 50 times faster growth takes place. Plant is more nutritious. It has scientifically proven that vitamin content is 50% more in hydroponically grown plants. And as you all know that these vegetables are readily available so that we can use the fresh vegetables in our daily life. Thank you.